Hi, I'm Dr. Sheela B.S. I'm an obstetrician and gynecologist. I'm practicing at Dr. Sheela Women's Wellness Clinic situated in R.R. Nagar, Bangalore. Urethritis is nothing but inflammation of the urethra. So, woman is more prone for infections mainly because of the short size of the urethra. It measures about 1.5 inches. It is commonly caused by bacteria. So, what are the organisms which causes urethritis? So, the most common organism is the E.coli and other bacteria which are present in the stool. Next common is the sexually transmitted diseases like gonorrhea caused by gonococci, trichomoniasis caused by the Trichomonas vaginalis, and another sexually transmitted disease called Chlamydia caused by the Chlamydia trichomatis, and herpes simplex can also lead to urethritis. So these are the sexually transmitted diseases which limits itself to the urethra. Sometimes if it is not treated properly, it can ascend to the reproductive organs and can cause pelvic inflammatory diseases and in future infertility. So woman who is having urethritis can manifest in different way. She may find it difficult to pass urine. Her initiation of act itself may be difficult and she may be passing very scanty urine. There can be painful micturation and she may experience abdominal cramps at times. And there can be a discharge, vaginal discharge, or there can be a purulent discharge from the urethral opening. In a man, he may notice blood in his semen or in the urine. So how to diagnose this particular condition? As I've already said, by looking at her symptoms, you can conclude that she is suffering from urethritis. Next thing is to examination of the abdomen as well as the genital examination. Urine can be tested for the bacteria and pus cells. And next, any vaginal discharge or a discharge from the urethra can be collected and tested for under microscopy. And blood, there is not much to suggest for the urethral infections, but definitely the other sexually transmitted diseases like syphilis and HIV can be ruled out. Majority of these patients may have these problems along. So the blood test, blood investigation is done mainly to rule out syphilis and HIV infections. Man has to be tested for the urine, look for the microscopy, and any blood cells are there that can be identified. How to manage these patients? It's a curable condition, can be managed very well, and complete cure can be there. So majority of the infections are because of the bacteria, so specific antibiotics can be given in those patients. If it's a gonococcal infection, then we have to treat it with a single dose of injection ceftriaxone 250 mg intramuscularly along with 1000 mg of azithromycin orally. Trichomonas infection can be treated with rinidazole, ornidazole, secnidazole, etc. And chlamydial infections can be treated with doxycycline. Herpes simplex infection leading to urethritis can be treated by acyclovir antiviral drugs. Majority of the patients, it can be a mixed infection where we have to use combination of drugs. So effectively, all these conditions can be treated, and if it is treated early, the patient can be completely asymptomatic and complications can be avoided. What are the complications associated with urethritis? As I've already told you, it can be effectively treated by antibiotics. If it is not treated timely and aggressively, the infection can spread from urethra to the bladder, ureter, and kidneys. It needs parenteral antibiotics. Again, further, if it is not treated at this stage, it can spread to the blood, leading to causing sepsis, and it's a life-threatening risk and it has to be very aggressively managed, otherwise we may lose the patient. Sexually transmitted diseases, sometimes if not treated properly, can ascend and involve the reproductive organs, leading to PID, and it may block the tubes also, causing ectopic pregnancies, sometimes even infertility. So majority of these patients should be treated, diagnosed effectively, timely, so that we can avoid all these complications. Last but not the least, how can you prevent these conditions? So there are certain measures which one can follow. Having safe sex is very important. Avoiding multiple partners is very important. Using condoms during intercourse. And get yourself tested whenever you have any doubt. And if you found yourself to be positive for some any kind of infections, your partner needs to be tested. And urethral hygiene is very, very important. Nowadays, vaginal wash lotions are available to keep the area clean as well as to maintain the pH, and they can be used. And regular intake of water in abundance is very, very important. And frequent urination and not holding on to the urine is important. And post intercourse, I think voiding urine is very important. So simple measures like this can prevent urethritis and avoid complications. Thank you.